Now see this question in front of you. On 1st of Jan 2007, a company held 200 units. Exam technique, first read the, determine the valuation of closing inventory and cost of sales using FIFO and weighted average cost means FCO. So weighted average cost means FCO. And FIFO means first in, first out. On 1st of Jan 2007, a company held 200 units of finished goods valued at 10 each. During Jan, the following transactions took place. So remember I told you, when you are receiving such type of a question, you have to make how many columns?
I can do this.
Make 3 columns, 1 row, then again 2nd row. Break the columns into 3 sub-columns. Done? What to write here? Inflow, issues, balance. What to write here? Quantity, rate, amount. Quantity, rate, amount. Quantity, rate, amount. Done? Everyone done? Now tell me, at the start of the question, they are giving you opening balance or not? How much is the opening balance? 200 units at the rate of 10 each. So how much is the total figure? 2000 or not? Right at 2000. So this is the start of the warehouse, 2000. During Jan, the following transactions took place. Kindly, you need to see the dates as well at the moment. In the first box, purchases are given. In the second box, sales are given. So can you tell me after 1st of Jan, what is the earliest date in the boxes below? 10th of Jan. What is happening? Receipts. How much I am purchasing? 300 units. How many? At the rate of 10.85. Can you tell me how much? How much? Three, two, five, five. 3255. Okay. Now what is happening in the warehouse? 200 are coming from the balance, 2000. And now this is going into the warehouse, 300, 10.85, 3255. Gate is closed. Gate is done. Moving on, can you tell me what is the date after 10th of Jan? 14th of Jan, what is happening? Sold means issues. So how much? 280 units. Now you will ignore the selling price. You will ignore the, because I am talking about the cost. I am talking about the cost. So units are 280, but I cannot get this 280 from this 200. We are talking about first in, first out. We are talking about, so out of this 280, can you tell me how can I get this 280? 200 I will get from here, 80 I will get from here. So 200 at the rate of 10 and 80 at the rate of 10.85. How much? Okay. Now what is the situation of warehouse? 200 gone. 300 minus 80. How much? At the rate of 10.85. How much? 2, 3. So this is the situation of warehouse. Closed. What is the next date after 14th of Jan? 20th or not? Receipts how much? At the rate of? How much? So I will update it. 220 at the rate of 10.85 are coming from the balance. And new figures are 350 at the rate of 11.5, which is 4025. Done? gate closed. After 20th of Jan, what is happening? 21st of Jan. How many units? 400 are going out. How to get this 400 units? 220 from here? Najmul, 220 from? And 400 minus 220, how much? 180 from this figure. 180 from? Done? At the rate of 10.85? At the rate of 11.5, how much? 2076. Out of this 350, I have taken 180. So, how many are remaining? Miss Ramsheela, getting it? So, tell me the answer and use your calculator as well, please. 350 minus 180, how much? At the rate of? How much? Gate closed. After 21st of Jan, what is happening? 20, after 21st, what is coming? 25th or 28th? 25th. So, 25th in the above box. How many units are coming in again? At the rate of? 30. How much? 50. Done? Gate closed. Now, last date, what is happening on 28th of Jan, my friends? What is happening on 28th of Jan? Issue, how much? 80. 80 I can take from 170? At the rate of? How much? 950. Out of 170, I have taken 80. How many are remaining? At the rate of? How much? 10? 10? And this 250 is remaining as it is. 250 at the rate of 30. How much? Now, postings are done. Postings are? What is the requirement? Calculate the valuation of closing inventory. What is closing inventory? The last box. This is closing inventory. Add these both figures. How much? 4 to 8. This is the value of closing inventory. The balance remaining in the warehouse. According to FIFO. According to? And cost of sales. And cost of sales as well. They are asking you. If you total this column, this is your cost of sale. Total this column, 2000 plus 868 plus 2387 plus 2070 plus 920. These are your cost of sales. Why? Because basically this sale issues column is the sales column. How much? 8245 is your cost of sale and 4285 is your closing inventory. Getting my point, everyone? Easy, difficult? Very easy. But whenever you are receiving a question on FIFO, FCO, follow this approach. No matter you are taking 5 minutes in the exam, follow this approach, otherwise you will do it wrong. Otherwise you will do it, I am telling you. Because some questions demand more time, some questions demand less time. So don't worry when you are making this thing in the exam. Make it. Getting my point? This approach is, I don't know, not written so much in the official answers. Okay? So, you need to make this approach. Solve questions like this every time so that you are quick in the exam to do this approach. Now, FIFO done. Yes, please.
So, that 4285
yeah.
Is
closing. Yeah. Cost of sales because of the column, if you can see. Column balance means what is remaining in the warehouse. Issues means what is the cost of sales? Half question done, half remaining. Now remember FCO, same approach, make three columns again. Pavel, where are the remaining handouts? Take the handouts. Give the remaining handouts to SM. Everyone has the handout? Everyone has the handout? Okay. Now we will solve through FCO. The first column is called. Second column. Third column. And we are solving through FCO this time. We are solving through FCO this time. What do you think? It will be easy or difficult as compared to FIFO? It is easier as compared to FIFO. I think it is easier. I don't know about you. Okay, how much was the balance at the start of the period? Write it as it is. How much? 200 units at the rate of 10. How much? 2000. We are solving through FCO, so write the heading FCO. Warehouse is closed at the moment. Miss Farin, after 1st of Jan, what is coming? 10th of Jan? How many units I am purchasing? At the rate of?
10.85.
Total how much?
3255.
Done. In the FIFO thing, if you remember, we wrote both of them separately. Now we are talking about average. You know how to take average? Total it divided by something like that. So you can do a mistake over here, like I used to do as well. The mistake you can do is take the average of both the rates. Can you tell me what is 10 plus 10.85 divided by 2? Plus 10.85, two rates are there, divided by 2, you will get the average. How much? Keep this thing in your mind, this figure, okay? This is wrong. This is wrong. Wrong approach. Now tell me, 200 are already present in the warehouse. I am purchasing 300 more. Total how much? Plus, tell me, what was the cost? Earlier, 2000. New cost is how much? Add both of them and tell me how much. 5255. Okay. Now divide this 5255 with 500. 5255 divide 500. 10 point? It is changed. 10 point how much? 51. That's it. Or there is some decimal places. Exact 10.51. This is the correct answer. Previously you calculated how much, which is wrong. It is wrong approach, it is correct. It is called weighted average. It is called, I am taking the weights of both the figures and then I am dividing it. Okay, easy, good. This is the main logic here. Okay, what is happening after 10th of Jan, 14th of Jan? What is happening on 14th of Jan? How much? In FCO method, this is the benefit for you. You can directly write the figure. In FIFO, we used to select. In FCO, no problem because all the inventory is valued at 10.51 now. This is the latest average amount. So 280 multiply by 10.51. How much? 294. I need answers, man. 29? Exact? If it is not exact, tell me the rounded figure. So it is 2943. 29? Round it off. Okay. What is happening after 14th of Jan, can you tell me? Twentieth of Jan, how much? At the rate of? Okay, wait. I have taken 280 out of this 500. How many are remaining? At the rate of?
10.5.
Total it how much?
2312.
Gate closed. Now I am purchasing 350 units at the rate of? Total it how much? Najmul, getting it? Done? Again getting this figure? Now again do the same thing. Add both the number of units, how much? 220 plus 350, how much? 2312 plus 4025, how much? 6? Divide 6337 by 570. Tell me till two decimal places. 11.12. Everyone is getting this figure in the calculator?
Yes.
Round it off to two decimal places. Miss Sana, use your calculator. Those of you who are not using the calculators at the moment, you will face difficulties later on. Experience, I am telling you. Calculate it, man. You are here to copy? If you are here to copy, no need to take the class. I will give you the video. Then copy. I will give you the slides, no problem. No need to write it as well. I will upload the slides. Write it and use your calculator. I told you or not. You need to be quick in your calculation. How? Practice it in the class. Always use the calculator. Gate closed. What is happening after 20th of Jan? 21st of Jan. How many units? I will use the latest rate. What is the latest rate? 400 multiplied by 11.12. How much?
448.
Okay. Out of 570, I have taken 400. How many are remaining? At the rate of 11.12, how much? 1889. Again getting it?
Yes.
Gate closed. After 21st of Jan, what is happening? After 21st of Jan, what is happening? 25th of Jan. Okay. So, I am purchasing again 250 at the rate of how much?
1890.
It is 1890.
Yes.
Samantha, calculate it again, please. 1890. Happy? 250 into 13, how much? Again do the same approach, remember? 170 plus 250, how much? 1890 plus 3250.
Sir, this part
I am
not getting.
See this. I want to take average. One approach is that this rate and this rate you add and divide by 2, which is wrong. What is the correct approach? These units are already present in the warehouse. I have purchased 250 more units. Add these both units, how much? This was the older cost. This is the new cost. Add these two costs, how much is the answer right here? And then divide this cost by these units, you will get the average. Now getting it? Total units, total cost. Then divide it, you will get the weighted average. How much? What should be written over here? 5140 divided by 420, how much?
24.
238 means 24. 238 means? I will try to keep extra class on mathematics. Then I will tell you how to round off. Okay, inshallah. Gate closed. Last event, what is happening? 28th of Jan. There is a sale of how much?
80.
Last event, 80. What is the rate we need to use? 12.24. How much? 12.24. Yes, please. Tahir? No calculator? Kindly bring it. This is financial accounting class. In exam, mobile not allowed. I need calculator in the next class. Otherwise, I will not allow you to sit in the class. Any problem? Done? So, 80 into 12.24, how much?
939.
Okay. Out of 420, I have taken 80. How many remaining?
340.
Into 12.24, how much? 4165. This is closing inventory. This 4161 is closing inventory. Getting it? And what is the cost of sales? Yes, Mr. Najmul. How to calculate cost of sale? By adding the third column of issues, this column. You will add all of these figures and you will get your cost of sales. How much? 8370. This is your cost of sales. Easy, difficult? Really? Okay. Okay. We can do a comparison. It is not required. I am telling you. So, can you tell me when we did the FIFO thing, how much was the closing inventory? And how much was the cost of sale? Okay. If I am doing Revit, if I am doing FIFO, if I am doing EFCO, okay. Now we are the accountant, okay. We need to do some magic. Okay. According to FIFO, what is the closing inventory? 4285. EFCO, what is the closing inventory? 4161. According to FIFO, what is the cost of sale?
8255.
And EFCO? Okay, you are the accountant of a company. Okay, inshallah, very soon. So, this is in front of you. And you know very well your manager. He will give you a promotion if you will do a good job. So, you are watching this slide. Can you tell me which method will report the higher profit? Why? Because closing inventory is higher in FIFO and closing inventory increases profit. You can also say cost of sales is lower in FIFO, so profit will be higher. So you can use FIFO if you want to increase your profit. Okay. By how much it will be increased? Can you tell me what is the difference between these two figures?
1.5.
This is some decimal discrepancy you people have done. Otherwise, it will be 4160. It will be 4160. Tell me the difference between these two figures. How much?
1 to 3. 1 to 5.
Okay. And what is the difference between these two figures? Yeah, of course, they will be same. The difference will be same because closing inventory is included in the cost of sale. I am trying to tell you, if you will use FIFO method, your profit will be increased by how much? $125. Very minimal amount. That's why both are allowed. But if you are using a particular method, you should go for it. You should. If you wish to change, only when you can change, if you are justifying the auditor, that it will lead to more presentable financial statements. Otherwise, you cannot change according to consistency concept. If you are changing, it is called change of accounting policy. Kindly write it, please. change of accounting policy. Examiner can ask you that a company is changing the inventory valuation method from FIFO to FCO or FCO to FIFO. This is a change in accounting policy or a change in accounting estimate. So what you will answer? Change of accounting policy. It is a change of accounting policy. This we will cover in the later classes when I will teach you International Accounting Standard number 8. Inshallah ta'ala. Any problem? Easy topic, difficult topic?
I can do this.